Okay, here we go. This is a song that Tone and I just wrote called The Sound of Friction. Here we go. Hello, friction, my old friend. I've come to ponder you again. Because this problem that I am doing requires an object to be moving. And this problem has caused me to beat my brain against the wall. It makes the sound of friction. You see, I've got this blocky thing resting on a coffee table. The table's tilted at 0 degrees, so I can calculate cosine with ease. And the block has a mass of 20 kilograms. It's made of Spam, which is short for spiced ham. So I've got this block of Spam, and it's attached to a rope. And the rope goes over a pulley at the edge of the coffee table. And the other side of the rope is attached to a fish. The fish is dead. It has a mass of X. The question tells us to find X so that the block slides off the table. And it tells us that Spam has a mu of 0.5 when it is at rest. And you ask, hey, what the hell is mu? It occurs to you that you know nothing about friction. Well, friction is a force opposing the motion. It depends on the mass of the block and not on the surface area, and also on the coefficient of friction, which is just a property of the two materials. The equation goes like this: friction equals n times mu, where n is the normal force acting orthogonally to the plane, and n is subject to Newton's second law, F equals ma. And here a is acceleration due to gravity. So now we calculate the force needed to exceed friction. Recall that friction equals n times mu, and n equals m times a. And then you multiply by the constant mu, which is 0.5, and your answer is 98 newtons. So the fish must cause a force greater than 98 newtons. And we calculate x this way: 90s is less than x times a, where a is the acceleration due to gravity. The answer says that x is greater than 10 kilograms. And now you know all about friction and how to apply it to the world. If you ever have an inclined plane underneath the block of Spam, and the Spam is connected to a fish, you'll know what to do. You'll say, physics, I love you.